What's up, everyone? I recorded this video on Wednesday, November 3rd, 2021, and it's 49 Fahrenheit, 9 degrees Celsius. It's 12:30 in the afternoon, and I'm here in Times Square. I'll be walking from Times Square to Central Park in this video. There are a few new things happening around Times Square that you should know about. Today is the first day that these Broadway show globes are installed. They'll be here until December 26th. They had this, I believe, last year or 2 years ago. But all those show globes are further down there. Yes. No, no problem. Times Square, always a hit with tourists. This is the mask for the Phantom of the Opera, Broadway's longest running show. I'm just gonna do a loop around of Times Square before I turn around and head towards Central Park. I figure this might be an informative video for people who haven't visited New York City before or want to know what's going on. Especially because Times Square and Central Park, I believe, are the top two tourist destinations in New York City. The prices here for the churros aren't too bad. It's $4 for a churro, $3 for a coffee. Here we have the Times Square street performers. The famous naked cowboy. The singing lady. And here are the new show globes in Times Square. Cinderella and the Wicked Witch. Oh, this one even has a little bow in the front. Seems to be a miniature apple tree in the middle. Looks like the Lion King is facing the wrong way. This one's very colorful. Love the face painting. This building over here with the 2021 on the top, that's where the New Year's Eve ball drops. It's one Times Square. The only tenant in that building is the Walgreens store on the first level. So for this walk, I'm going to walk up 7th Avenue to Central Park. Central Park's southern boundary is 59th Street. It's also codenamed Central Park South. All of Central Park's street boundaries are named after their directions except for 5th Avenue. There's a Central Park West and there's also a Central Park North, but there's no Central Park East. This is 46th Street. Between here and 6th Avenue is known as Little Brazil. Let's go back towards the middle. I don't want to walk underneath that scaffolding. We'll get a better view of Times Square again. These red steps are a very good place to be if you want to take photos. It's not open all the time though. They do close it for special events and during inclement weather. Uh-oh. Someone spilled their coffee. Before I head north to Central Park though, I did forget to mention this art exhibit. This one over here is all made from fingernails. And there's a nice fountain inside. Called A Fountain for Survivors, and it's here until December 8th. Time to make my way towards Central Park.
Hop on a boat.
For this route, I prefer to walk up 7th Avenue rather than Broadway. It's not that I don't think Broadway's nice over here, but there's more stuff to see on 7th Avenue. Alright, I don't know exactly what happened, but I had to resume recording because I walked about 5 minutes more and I realized that the camera was off. It's a good thing I realized that it wasn't recording. Renaissance Hotel. Here at Mia's Brooklyn Bakery, they have a breakfast special, which isn't too bad considering that it's right in Times Square. I saw it on the other side of this billboard. Any breakfast item with a regular coffee or tea for $5. The hop on and hop off sightseeing bus. I've actually never taken one of these before. Maybe I should try it one day, even though I live here, just for the experience. Ray's Pizza. There's plenty of Ray's Pizza all around New York City. Some of them ranging from names such as Original Ray's, Famous Original Ray's, Famous Ray's. But the first ever Ray's location, are you gonna yield, dude? First ever Ray's location is where the Prince Street Pizza location is now. And it's only half of the space. But there's a lot of great options for pizza places in New York City. My preferred pizza place around Times Square is Joe's Pizza, located near the southern section of Times Square. This is the location of the Winter Garden Theater. Looks like they're preparing for something. Manhattan at Times Square Hotel. I like the chandeliers in the lobby. Also another big hotel across the street, the Sheraton. I've been inside the Sheraton before. It's a really nice lobby. I never noticed this before, but this over here is the pickup or drop-off location for the Hampton Jitney going to East Long Island. It's another option for public transportation other than the Long Island Railroad. I've only been out to the Hamptons once, and that was with the train. As I said before, Ray's Pizza is all around. This one's called Famous Original Ray's Pizza. But in addition to pizza slices, they also have Hot Heroes, Philly cheesesteaks, pastas, and even buffalo wings. I wonder what's going to happen to this large vacant lot. Premier Deli Cafe. Actually looks pretty good in here. There's a lot of people inside. And the prices don't seem too bad either. Park Central Hotel. Looks great with all these plants in the front. And over here is where you'd rent bicycles and scooters. One hour for $25 and 2 hours for $40 for an electric bicycle. A pro tip, if you want to rent a bicycle in New York City, you can use the city's bike sharing system called City Bike. I believe it's only $3 for up to 30 minutes. And you can get a day pass for $12, I believe. But you do have to return the bikes in 30-minute increments or you get charged late fees. And even if you pay those late fees, it'll still be way cheaper than the bike rental place over there. I don't think the quality of the bike is going to be as nice, but you'll still get a good value. Now we're at 57th Street, Carnegie Hall Performing Arts Center, at the southeast corner. We've got the super tall skyscrapers at Billionaire's Row. That's 111 57th Street, 157 57th Street, and the Nordstrom Tower, or Central Park Tower. That's the tallest building in New York City by floor height.
Yeah, not around the kids, I mean.
Also, there's another bike and scooter rental place right over there. Let's take a look at that. Central Park is only a block away from us. The place, Central Park Bike Tours, bikerent.nyc. supposedly this Cafe Serafina is supposed to open in summer 2021, but looks like they're behind schedule now. Would have been nice for this to be open in the summertime. Here we are, Central Park South. Across the street at the Artisan's Gate. This is where you get your horse and buggy rides throughout Central Park. Going that way, you'll head towards Columbus Circle. And to the right, you'll head towards Fifth Avenue and Grand Army Plaza, the southeast corner of Central Park and the busiest entrance. All these buildings lined up across the street from Central Park are all luxury skyscrapers. And now we're entering Central Park. I think this is the route we'll take. We'll head past the Chess and Checkers House, the Woolman Rink, and we'll loop back around towards the pond. Right now, I think it's just a little bit too early to see peak fall foliage, but we'll see a lot of different trees turning colors already. Central Park was designed by Calvert Vaux and Robert Olmsted. I still believe this is one of the greatest man-made parks in the world. Wait a second, who did I say it was designed by? It's Calvert Vaux and Frederick Law Olmsted. I don't know where Robert came in the mix. Got some buskers in Central Park. What's happening here? noticed a lot of squirrel activity in the park today. Right now it's the autumn, so I believe that many of these squirrels are digging up the ground to look for nuts and other food that they buried throughout the summer and early fall season. The thing is, squirrels have a pretty bad memory, so they just bury their food all over the place and they'll find other squirrels' nuts and food. Like, probably over there, that's what happened. He said, that was my food, and chased off after the other squirrel. All right, we're going to walk under this archway now, and we'll pass by the Woolman Rink. The Drip Rock Arch. This archway passes under the Central Park Loop Road. It's popular for joggers, people exercising, cyclists, and I believe it's a 6-mile loop around Central Park. There's also a shorter loop, I think it lasts maybe 2 miles or so, that goes across 72nd Street. Let's see the progress on the Woolman Rink. The Woolman Rink is a great spot to come if you want to take pictures. Looks like it's almost done setting up. There's people working on the rink already. Let's head towards the pond. This path on the western side of Woolman Rink is the most direct way to get to the pond. a beautiful day to do a walk in the park. Over here you can see the super tall skyscrapers on 57th Street that we passed by earlier. There sure are a lot of fallen leaves here. But not too much color yet. Now this area to the right is a hidden secret, or I should say a hidden gem in Central Park called the Hallett Nature Sanctuary. This area is pretty much an untouched area of Central Park. Well, it looks like you're not just going to see squirrels in Central Park, but there's a Norway rat over there. They are not shy at all. Extremely pretty here by the pond. This bridge is always busy with tourists. That was the Gap Style Bridge. Thank you. this tree actually touches the water. Let's see what kind of birds we could find by the pond. Pigeons and geese. All right, folks, if you enjoyed this video walking from Times Square to Central Park, then be sure to smash the like button for me. Subscribe for some more videos like these, and I'll see you next time. Take care, everyone. Bye-bye.